我们请看提摩太前书三章十六节。
Let us turn to 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16.
提摩太前书三章十六节。
1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16.
那么这段经文提到啊，我们天上真神啊，非常伟大的。那么有关敬虔的奥秘。
So this passage describes the great mystery of godliness pertaining to our God in heaven.
那我们这一节要来跟家分啊，要来跟家分啊，跟大家分享第三个部分啊。
So in this session, we'll talk about the third point.
我们要先了解啊，天上这个真神，他告诉我们说，一个用虔诚的心要敬拜他的人。
So firstly, we must understand, for our God in heaven, one who worships Him in godliness.
那么必须要先从这一位道成肉身的神，就是耶稣基督的身上来入门。
And this person must enter through God manifested in the flesh, who is Jesus Christ.
然后看耶稣基督他所留下的榜样到底是什么。
And to look at the examples that Jesus Christ himself has left behind.
然后我们再从他所留下的榜样当中，我们来勉励我们自己怎么过敬虔的生活。
And from the examples that he has left with us, we learn how to live a life of godliness.
好，那我们现在来看哈，这个十六节的最后这一个部分。
So we will now look at the last part of verse 16.
好，那么这里提到说啊，我们的耶稣基督哈，他被接在荣耀里面。
So here it mentions that our Jesus Christ was received up in glory.
基督我们的神他道成肉身啊，名字叫耶稣。
So when Christ was manifested in the flesh in the world, his name was called Jesus.
那这一位神他是带着没有罪的生命系统，他降生来到这个世界。
This God came to earth as a life form without sin.
好，他为我们啊。这个留下的啊，进入天国永生的啊，这个真理。
And he left with us the truth concerning salvation to enter the heavenly kingdom.
那更可贵的是，他用他的啊生命啊，他牺牲了他的生命，那么用他的血，让我们也能够进入没有罪的生命系统里面。
So what is more precious is that through his crucifixion, he has given us a path of life to enter into this lifeless.Sinless life.
所以我们今天也跟耶稣基督一样，在灵里面被神宣告我们是没有罪的。
So just as Jesus Christ is, we are pronounced to be without sin as he is.
所以我们要保守神所给我们的圣洁。
So we must maintain the holiness that God has given us.
那么来这个世界上过着敬虔敬拜神的生活。
So that we can live a life that is godly and one which is worshipful of God.
那当耶稣他完成了十字架救赎的恩典之后，
So after Jesus had completed the salvation on the cross,
按照我们天上真神的计划，他为我们到地里面经过三天三夜的这个受苦。
And according to God's plan, he suffered when he was buried in the ground for 3 days.
然后耶稣基督他就复活了。
And then Jesus Christ was then resurrected.
那因为耶稣基督复活表示什么事情呢？
And because he had resurrected, what does it signify?
表示耶稣基督他战胜了阴间死亡的权柄。
It means that he has overcome the power of death in Hades.
那我跟慕道朋友讲到这边的时候，
So when I talked to this with my truth-seeking friends,
我们慕道朋友又有意见呢。
And then our truth-seeking friends have their opinions as well.
他说传道请教你好吗？
So a preacher can ask you a question.
你说耶稣为我们钉十字架，经过三天之后又复活。
So you say that Jesus Christ was crucified, died, and was buried in the ground for 3 days, and afterwards he was resurrected.
那是你们基督教这本圣经写的。
So this is what is recorded in your Christian Bible.
那宗教信仰是这样子哈。
So this is how religious systems work.
你传。无论是什么基督教、道教、回教、喇嘛教，或者是统一教，你传嘛，你可以怎么样讲，随便你讲。
So whether you are Christian, Taoist, Buddhist, or whatever, you can preach what you want to say.
那信不信在我。
So whether you believe or not, it's up to you.
所以你现在讲说你们的这个救主耶稣基督哈，经过三天复活了，你讲嘛。可是我信不到啊，我没看到啊。
So you might say, oh, your Lord Jesus Christ was resurrected after 3 days, being dead for 3 days. That's what you say, but I'm I do not believe in it because I have not seen it happen.
那么基督的复活有见证吗？
So was there a testimony concerning the resurrection of Jesus Christ?
有证据吗？
Is there evidence for this?
好，那这个证据是我能够掌控得到的。你不要再讲圣经说有啊，你看他的门徒画多少人看到，那也是你们圣经写的啊。
So it's the actual hard evidence that I can see, and not just a quotes or citations in the Bible.
在台湾很难得碰到这样这个怎么讲啊？很刁钻啊，哈，钻牛角尖的基督徒啊，哎，慕道者啊，哈。
So it's quite rare for us to meet such a difficult truth seeker.
好，我们来看约翰福音十六章。
So let us turn to John chapter 16.
约翰福音十六章第七节。
John chapter 16, verse 7.
请看约翰福音十六章第七节
John chapter 16 verse 7
这句话是耶稣基督还在树上传讲天国福音信息的时候他所说的话
So this was spoken by Jesus when he was preaching the gospel about the heavenly kingdom
耶稣说我将真情告诉你们我去是与你们有益的我若不去保惠师就不到你们这里来我若去就差他来这里什么叫做保惠师呢
So who is the helper mentioned here?
那当然我们引证这个约翰福音十四章的十六节跟十七节
So of course we can cite John chapter 14 verses 14
那么所谓的保惠师就是神要赏赐给我们的圣灵
So the helper refers to the Holy Spirit that God is to give us
所以耶稣还在这个树上传讲天国福音的时候
So when Jesus was speaking concerning the gospel of heaven
耶稣就跟他的门徒说我告诉你们一件事实
So he told his disciples I'll tell you this fact
如果我离开你们我回归到天上荣耀的宝座
So if I leave you and return to my heavenly throne
那么我会把保惠师赏赐下来就是我会把圣灵赏赐下来
I would then send the helper to you, which is to say, I will send the Holy Spirit to you.
那如果我还没有离开你们，还跟你们一起生活的时候，保惠师圣灵是不会降临的。
So if I do not go away and remain with you, the helper will not come.
那这种情形好像什么呢？
So what can we compare the situation to?
我记得大概是1993年的时候，
So I recall the time in 1993.
我爸爸当时还活着。
My father was still alive back then.
那有一天我当那个时候我爸爸差不多有七个孙子了，内外孙加起来有七个。
So my father had about seven grandchildren altogether.
那刚好有机会他要到美国去访问教会，那么其中有一站已经知道了，叫迪士尼乐园。
So when he was to go to the States to visit, he knew that there was one stop that he had to make, which is Disneyland.
所以他就把七个孙子都叫来，来来来来来，公司里。
And he called his seven grandchildren to come to him.
就跟他讲，跟这些孙子炫耀了，阿公要去迪士尼乐园。
And he was boasting to his grandchildren that granddad is about to go visit Disneyland.
我们家那些小朋友一听到迪士尼乐园怎么样，眼睛就亮起来。为什么？唐老鸭、米老鼠，很多卡通影片，他们都很熟啊，卡通人物啊。
And so the eyes of the grandchildren lit up when they heard Disneyland because they thought of characters like Donald Duck and Mickey Mouse.
所以这些孙子就问他阿公啊，最大的才七岁啊，这个最大的问他阿公啊，阿公真的吗？你会不会骗我们？
So the eldest, who was 7 years old at the time, asked his granddad, are you lying to us?
阿公说真的啊。这孙子跟他讲说拿证据来啊，不然你就是骗我们啊。
So the grandchild said to him, show us your evidence, otherwise you're lying to us.
所以我爸爸就跟他讲说好，我到了迪士尼乐园之后，我会买一张迪士尼乐园的明信卡片。
And so he told his grandchild, when I reach Disneyland, I'll buy a postcard for you.
然后我会把那个唐老鸭戴的那一顶帽子，那个贴纸，主要，请问大家有几种你知道吗？唐老鸭那一顶帽子有几种颜色你知道吗？
So do we know
我知道，我知道。
How many types of hats does Donald have?
他说主要有贴纸，我就把它贴在明信片上面，我就寄回来给你们。
So whatever hats he has, I'll collect the stickers for them and stick it on the postcard and send it back to you.
你们接到这张明信片, 看到这些贴纸, 哈, 这些帽子, 我全部都会买回来。
And whatever hat you, sticker of the hat you see on the postcard, those hats I'll buy for you.
好, 那, 真的, 哈, 我爸爸到了迪士尼乐园, 哈, 诶, 真的寄了一张卡片, 上面就贴了唐老鸭, 总共有六种, 啊。
And so when he reached Disneyland, he bought six stickers with six different colors.
哇，我们家那些小朋友一接到这个明信卡片，哈，哇，全部哈欢呼大叫啊！耶，阿公去迪士尼乐园呐，有证据呀！
And so when they received the postcard, they were all cheering, saying that Granddad really went to Disneyland.
那还没有回来哈，帽子全部都分配好了。 我要蓝色的，他要黄色的，这个要绿色的，帽子全部都分配好了啊。And
so before he came back, he already arranged who would get which colored hat.
那等到他要回来的那一天哈，应该是清晨了哈，台湾时间清晨大概六点都会到台湾。And
so he was due to return to Taiwan in early morning in Taiwan.
那一天晚上我就糟糕了哈。And
that night,
因为我们家三个啊，七个孙子，我们家占三个啊。
So among the seven grandchildren, three were my children.
睡到半夜，一点多，我那个大女儿来把我叫，爸爸起来起来，你看阿公回来了没有？我一看，一点多还没啦。So
my eldest daughter came to me and woke me up at 1 a.m.
你再去睡觉啦，时间到了我会叫你啦。And
I told her to go back to sleep.
三点多换老二来叫我。
And then at 3:30, my second child came to me.
四点多老三来叫我，那个晚上真的不好睡。
And around 4 a.m, my youngest came to me.
那等到真的阿公回到家，我载他们回去，不是说阿公欢迎你啊，阿公唐老鸭帽子拿来。
And so when Granddad came back, the first thing they said wasn't welcome back, but where show me the hats.
这个叫证据，是吗？
And this is evidence.
我到了那边。
And when I reached there.
我寄的东西回来。
I sent something.
那我们在这边的人就能够深信，真的他已经到那边了。So
allowing us who are here to believe that he has truly reached.
所以圣灵是证明耶稣基督已经复活回到天上荣耀的宝座的一个证据啊。So
the Holy Spirit is one piece of evidence that our Jesus Christ has resurrected and returned to his throne, glorious throne in heaven.
Okay, 透过我们的祷告很熟悉，我们就体会到圣灵跟我们同在。
And familiar to us is when we pray, we experience the Holy Spirit abiding with us.
所以虽然我们眼睛没有看到耶稣复活,
so even though with our eyes we haven't seen Jesus Christ resurrected,
可是因着他所赏赐给我们的圣灵,
but through the Holy Spirit that he has accorded us,
我们也能够有证据确认耶稣基督真的复活战胜阴间死亡的权柄。
We have the evidence that he has truly resurrected and overcome the power of death.
那耶稣基督复活之后，到底他到哪里去呢？
So where did Jesus go after he had resurrected?
如果我们看《使徒行传》第一章的第九节，
If you look at Acts chapter 1 verse 9，
这个是记载耶稣基督他回到天上的过程。
So this records the process of Jesus ascending to heaven.
那么圣经记载说，他是有一朵云彩把他接去，然后大家就看不见他了。
So this passage records that he was taken up and the cloud received him out of their sight.
到底接到哪里去呢?
So where was he received to?
我们还要再看约翰福音17章第5节。
So we can also look at John chapter 17 verse 5.
那么这节经文提到说，提到耶稣基督跟天上的父说，我现在要跟你共享未造世界之前我们所共同拥有的荣耀。
So here Jesus says to the Father, O Father, glorify me together with yourself with the glory which I had with you before the world was.
14节说，我在地面上你交托我应当要完成的工作，我做好了，我完成了。And
in verse 14, it says, Jesus says that I have given them your word according to how you've instructed me to do.
那第五节耶稣说，我要回到你的荣耀里面去。And
in verse 15,
17章第5节，and in chapter 17 verse 5,
it mentions how he will return to the glory.
所以耶稣他是回到神的荣耀里面去啊。So
in fact, Jesus had returned to the glory of God.
那什么叫做神的荣耀呢？So
what is the glory of God?
我们来看一看神住在哪里。
So let us see where God lives.
圣经不是说神住在天堂，找不到这样子的字眼。
So the Bible does not record that God lives in heaven.
我们来看提摩太前书第六章。
So let us turn to 1 Timothy chapter 6.
提摩太前书六章十六节。
1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 16.
提摩太前书六章十六节。
1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 16.
就是那独一不死住在人不能靠近的光里，是人未曾看见，也是不能看见的。
Who alone has immortality, dwelling in unapproachable light, whom no man has seen or can see, to whom be honor and everlasting power.
我们只有一个神，是独一真神。
We only have one God, and He is the true God.
他的生命没有结束的时候。
He does not have an end to His life.
他只是完成了世上的这个救恩的工作，他还是回到天上去。
So after he had completed his salvation work on earth, he returned to heaven.
所以约翰福音三章十六节说除了从天降下能救在天的人子。三章十六节。
So in John chapter 3 verse 16.
在约翰福音三章十三节哈 ，OK。
John chapter 3 verse 13。
圣经讲说哈，说除了从天降下能救在天的人子，没有人升过天。
No one has ascended to heaven, but he who came down from heaven, that is the Son of God.
那这种神观哈，就是要用灵的角度哈去看他哈，我们才有办法了解。
So our understanding is only we can only obtain this understanding if we look at it from the perspective of God.
我们不能够用物质的个体的角度去看它。
But we cannot view this from a material perspective.
好像高天的空气它降临在我们的地表上，它能就还在高天，这样懂吗？
So it is as if air descended from heaven, but it still remains above.
那这个就是神的存在，神存在的一个样式啊，因为神是灵啊。
So this is how God exists because He is a spirit.
那这个灵的特性是什么呢？
So what are the characteristics of the spirit?
神的属性我们要了解它。
We must understand the nature of God.
我们可以参考以弗所书第四章。
We can look at Ephesians chapter 5.
第四章第六节。
Chapter 4 verse 6.
那么这段经文提到说我们只有一位神。
So this verse tells us that we only have one God.
那这一位神呢，超乎众人之上。
And this one God is above all.
冠乎众人之中，在我们身体四周围。
Through all and in you all.
然后呢，住在众人之内。
And lives in.
也能够进入到我们的身体里面。
And he is able to enter into us.
那刚好在神所创造的物质的东西里面有一样东西，就是这种属性。
So when God created all the material things on this earth, this was the one thing he.
那它叫空气。
And he.
空气在我们之上， and, 也在我们身体四周围，也能够进入我们的身体里面。
So air is above us, around us, and can enter us.
空气现在在英国，空气现在也在非洲啊，也在台湾啊，也在美国啊，无处不在啊。
So air is everywhere, whether we're in the UK, in Africa, in Taiwan.
那空气是地球版的。
So air belongs to the earth.
那神的灵呢，是宇宙版的，充满在整个宇宙当中。
So air is of the earth, but God is of the universe. And He fills the universe.
所以我们可以用这样子的角度来了解我们这一位神的存在。
So from this angle, we can understand the existence of God.
那现在我们看到的提摩太前书六章十六节这样告诉我们。
So in 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 16.
说我们的神他没有生命的终结。
Tells us that God has immortality.
那他住在哪里呢？
But where does he dwell?
住在人不能靠近的光里面。
He dwells in unapproachable light, whom no man has seen or can see.
我们没有办法看见他。
We cannot see him.
那连他住的地方，我们也听不，没有，从来没有听过。那到底是什么地方啊？
Nor have we heard of where he dwells. So where does he actually dwell?
那我们圣经干脆，我们的神告诉我们说，我就是光啊，神就是光啊。
So the Bible tells us that God himself is light.
在约翰一书第五章的第五节。
So in 1 John chapter 5 verse 5.
那他的意思是什么呢？
So what does this mean?
他的意思就是说，神说我就住在荣耀里面。
It tells us that God lives in glory.
这个光你去看就是灿烂，就是灿烂的意思。
And this light is bright.
就是眼睛没有办法看见，没有办法直视的那一种，那一种我们讲亮点吧，
So bright that we are not able to physically see it.
那我们这本圣经常常就用荣耀来代表神啊。神的荣耀，神就住在荣耀里面，住在光里面，因为神本身就是光。
So, the Bible often tells us that God dwells in glory because God Himself is the light.
所以我们的神就是被接到荣耀里面去了。
And so our God has been received into glory.
那我们的神被接到荣耀，他也告诉我们说，将来我要接你们也是到荣耀里面去。
So our God also tells us that I have been received up in the glory and I will receive you into glory.
我们来看罗马书第八章。
We can turn to Romans chapter 8.
罗马书第八章，请看29节。
Romans chapter 8 verse 29.
罗马书八章29节。
Romans chapter 8 verse 29.
因为他预先所知道的人，就预先定下效法他儿子的模样，使他儿子在许多弟兄中做长子。三十节，预先所定下的人又招他们来，所招来的人又称他们为义，所称为义的人又叫他们得荣耀。我们在灵里面被耶稣基督所招，我们已经被神宣告是没有罪的。
So as we have been called in the Spirit by Jesus, we are considered sinless.
那我们被神宣告无罪，圣经说，那将来我们的神就让我们进入到他的荣耀里面，就跟耶稣基督一样。
So since we have been declared sinless by God, He will receive us up into His glory to be with Jesus Christ Himself.
所以耶稣基督他是所有弟兄中的长子，他已经做了模范，那么走了一条进入荣耀里面的一条道路。
So because Jesus Christ was the firstborn among many brethren, he has shown us the way to be received up into his glory.
那我们今天也是跟随耶稣的脚步，将来我们要进入到神的荣耀里面。
So today,
也许我们的观念说那个叫做天国啦，或者天堂啦，
So today we will follow in Jesus' footsteps to go towards his glory as well in this place we call heaven.
但是现在有一个非常重要的重点。
But there's an important point to make now.
谁能保证我能进入到神的荣耀里面？
Who can guarantee that one can enter the glory of God?
我们知道将来我们也要跟耶稣一样被接到神的荣耀里面。
We know that in the future we will be like Jesus Christ and we will be received into God's glory.
那耶稣他进入到神的荣耀，那到底耶稣是在那里做什么？
So now that Jesus has been received into the glory of God, what is he doing then now?
我们来看希伯来书第一章。
We can turn to Hebrews chapter 1.
希伯来书第一章第三节。
Hebrews chapter 1 verse 3.
我们看下半节。
We can look at the second half.
希伯来书第一章第三节。
Hebrews chapter 1 verse 3.
他洗净了人的罪，就坐在高天至大者的右边。第三节最后这句话。
When he had by himself purged our sins, sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high.
耶稣基督回到神荣耀的宝座，回到那个地方去。圣经说他是坐在神的右边。
So when Jesus returned to the God's glorious throne, he sat. So this verse tells us that he sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high.
好，那希伯来书十章十二节也是这样说。
So this is also the same as described in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 12.
说耶稣基督他一次把自己钉在十字架，完成救赎的恩典之后，十章十二节。
So in chapter 10, verse 12, it tells us that after Jesus had offered one sacrifice for sins forever.
那么他现在一样他坐在就在神的右边坐下了。
That he sat down at the right hand of God.
那请问神的右边是哪一边？
So, question. So, what is the right hand side of God?
我问这个问题，好像说，因为神是灵嘛，神是灵哈。
I ask this question.
那我问这个问题，好像问大家说，你现在是坐在空气的右边还是左边？
So this.
因为传道你问这个很奇怪哈。
So this is the same as asking, are you sitting to the left of right or air? So this question is very peculiar.
我不知道我现在是在空气的右边还是左边，我就知道我浸在空气里面，是不是？
So I do not know if I'm to the left or to the right of the air. I just know I'm with around the air surrounds me.
那什么叫做坐在神宝座的右边呢？
So what does it mean to sit at the right hand of God?
那么他的意思，因为犹太人是以右为尊的。
So because the Jewish people set right as a precedent.
所以他的意思就是说，哦，他被高举进入到神的荣耀里面之后，被神尊为大。
So it means that after he had been received into the glory of God, he was honored by God.
叫坐在神的右边。
Which is to say, he sat down at the right hand of God.
那耶稣基督会不会站起来？
So can Jesus,
因为他现在是坐在神的右边，你猜他会不会站起来？
Because he's now sat down at the right hand of God, can he actually stand up?
我先讲一个，一个典故哈。
So I'll tell you another story.
哈利路亚颂是谁做的，大家知道吗？
So do we know who composed the Hallelujah chorus?
这个歌剧的神剧里面，有一个叫这个弥赛亚神曲。
So in this religious opera, there's a part that's called the Messiah.
那这个弥赛亚神曲当中有一段叫哈利路亚颂。
So in this Messiah chorus, there's in this composition, Messiah, there's a bit called the Hallelujah chorus.
那这个创作的人叫韩德尔。
So the composer was Handel.
那他第一次在我们英国这个演出。
So the first time he performed in the UK.
是1743年的时候。
Was in the year 1743.
那当时我们英国的王叫乔治二世。
So the king on the throne at the time was George II.
那么他也进去歌剧院去聆听韩德尔大歌剧家韩德尔他所创造的弥赛亚神曲。
And he also entered the theater to listen to this great Messiah composed by Handel.
那么在历史上就做了这样子的记录。
So this is a historical record.
当这个英王乔治二世听到哈利路亚颂起来的时候他马上从他的座位站起来立正。
So when King George II heard the chorus started to play Hallelujah, he stood up from his throne.
然后一直聆听到整个哈利路亚颂结束以后，他才重新坐下去。
And he stood throughout the performance and only sat down when it ended.
那么大家会解读，到底我们这个王做的这样子的动作是什么意思啊？
So we might want to interpret why he did what he did.
他说，我感动，我深深感觉到这样子的乐曲是天上才有的，不应该出现在人间。
So he said that he was truly moved and felt that as if though this piece of music should only have existed in heaven and not on earth.
所以我为了表达对天上这位神极度的尊重。
So to show my great respect for our God in heaven.
那也感谢韩德尔他能够创作出这样子的天上的乐曲，所以我要站起来听，表示我对他们的尊敬。
And to thank Handel for composing this heavenly tune, so I stood up to show my respects.
坐着然后呢看到某些场景可能我们会很激动激动之下我们的动作是站起来
So if we are sat down and we see something that agitates us, we must stand up.
那圣经里面讲什么
So what does the Bible tell us?
在哥林多前书四章的第九节
So in 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 9,
保罗说神把我们这一些使徒明明的列在幕后
So it tells us that Paul tells us that for I think that God has displayed us the apostles last.
在哥林多前书四章九节
In 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 9.
他说我们好像定了赎罪的囚犯
As men condemned to death.
那什么叫做明明列在幕后呢
So what does it mean to be displayed as last?
他的意思就是说就人的地位就人的价值来讲神所拣选的这些将来有机会进入神国的人他们都是卑微的啦在这个地面上大多数都是卑微的啦
So those who have been chosen by God in the eyes of the people of the earth they are of the least
你可以参考哥林多前书第一章
So we can also refer to 1 Corinthians chapter
1从26节以下的经文
From the passage from verses 26 on
this 保罗告诉哥林多教会说你们蒙召的按着肉体来说第一个有智慧的不多
So here Paul tells us For you see your calling brethren That not many wise according to the flesh Not many mighty, not many noble are called
那有能力就是很有才华的人也不多
So to one who is mighty also has many talents.
有尊贵的也不多, 就是社会高阶单位的人也不多。
So nor are there many nobles who have high status in society.
所以我们教会很难得看到高阶的社会高阶的人数是神的门徒了，很难得看到了。
So in this, in the world today, we rarely see that those who are noble become God's people.
我们都是一般老百姓啊，叫贩夫走卒的。
So we're just commoners living day by day.
很辛苦在这个地面上，透过我们劳心劳力的工作在生活的。
And we work and toil and labor in this world.
那27节，保罗又讲，神拣选的树上什么样的人呢？
So in verse 27, what kind of persons has God chosen instead?
这个愚拙的，就是笨笨的，不大有智慧的。
So God has chosen the foolish things.
然后呢，树上软弱的，无依无靠，时常在悲伤当中过日子的。
And God has chosen the weak things of the world to put to shame the things which are mighty.
然后28节说，树上卑贱的，没有社会地位的，是属于下阶单位的人。
And in verse 28, and the base things of the world to refer to people who have no status in society.
然后被人厌恶的，以及那什么都没有的。
And the things which are despised, God has chosen, and the things which are not.
所以我们的神说，我们的神把我们这些他的门徒都列入在幕后了。 地位、价值在人的世界都是属于低下阶层的。
So for us as disciples chosen by God in this world, we have no status and no power.
那我们在基督徒生活在这个世界是演戏呀，演一台戏呀，演这一台人生的信仰大戏呀。
So as Christians living in this world, it is as if though we are playing a role in this world.
那给谁看呢？
So who are we showing this to?
都给世界的人看啊，看一看我们这些基督徒到底跟你们有什么不一样啊。
To show to the world, to demonstrate to them how different we are as Christians.
然后呢，给天使看啊。
To show to the angels.
好，那这个天使它的原文叫做神的使者了。
And so angels,
不是单主的天使了。
So angels in the original text refers to messengers of God.
包括耶稣基督都是神的使者哦。
Including even Jesus Christ himself is a messenger.
在希伯来书3章1节的经文，大家可以去看。
And this is recorded in Hebrews chapter 3, verse 1. We can read this in our own time.
所以希伯来书3章1节提到说，耶稣啊，耶稣也是神所差派的使者啊，要来完成神的工作的。
So in Hebrews chapter 3, verse 1, it tells us that Jesus was a messenger sent by God to complete the work of God.
那我们就是在这个世界上来演一场人生的信仰的大戏。你要演得精彩哦，对不起，你真的要演得精彩哦。
So we have come to this world to play a role of faith, and we must make it interesting.
演到将来你要离开这个世界的时候，我们的耶稣看得非常感动，他离开他的宝座，站起来，打开双手迎接我们回家。And
in the same way, when after we have finished playing this role, Jesus is truly touched, and he leaves his throne to come to receive us back into his own glory.
圣经刚好记载一位人物就是这样。
So the Bible records one such character.
我们来看《使徒行传》第7章。
In Acts chapter 7.
使徒行传第7章。
In Acts chapter 7.
好，请看55节。
Verse 55.
使徒行传第7章55节。
Acts chapter 7, verse 55.
好。 这里是司提环，他在接受审判的时候。So
this was when Stephen was receiving judgment.
你看圣经记载说，这个众人都非常愤怒，像司提亚怎么样，咬牙切齿。So
we find that the mob was cut to the heart and they were gnashing at him with
their teeth. 那55节就讲到说，司提环怎么样，被圣灵充满，定睛望天，然后看见神的荣耀，再来呢？ 又看见耶稣站在神的右边，好，耶稣站起来了。So
55, but he, being full of the Holy Spirit, gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God, and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. 56, and said, Look, I see the heavens open, and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God.
他本来是坐着的。So
he was originally sat down.
那是耶稣他现在看到司提环在人生的历程当中演出的这么好的一出戏。 一出信仰为耶稣基督所做的工，付出他的生命，这样子的一部大戏。
But he had seen that Stephen had played this great role in demonstrating his faith towards Jesus Christ during the course of his life.
所以耶稣基督他在情绪激动当中他也站起来他打开双手迎接素梯王回到神的荣耀里面
And because Jesus was so moved he stood up opened up his arms and received Stephen back to him
所以我们如果从这个角度我们来看
So if we look at it from this perspective
人一个基督徒最重要的最重要的是什么
So what is the most important thing for a Christian
是你要死在主里面
That you must die in the Lord
这一节经文大家都很熟
So we are very familiar with this passage
启示录14章13节
In Revelations chapter 14 verse 13
因为圣经里面我们的神他这样告诉我们
So in the Bible our God tells us
这个是天上所下来的神告诉我们的话所以圣经说从天上有声音说
So in verse 13 Then I heard a voice from heaven saying to me
我们的神从天上有声音下来告诉老院说写下来哦写下来把这句话写下来
So a voice from heaven God told Elder John to write this down
说从今以后在主里面而死的人有福的
Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on
死亡是一种福气
So to die is a blessing
这个是圣经神给我们的观念
So this is
一般人大概没有办法体会
So this is a concept given to us through the Bible and normal people wouldn't be able to understand
那如果我们的死亡要变成是一种属灵的福气那重点是你要死在主里面啊这个是关键点啊
So if we wish for our death to become a spiritual blessing we must die in the Lord this is the key
我们看这本圣经很多这种相对性的一个对比的一个例子
So 在圣经里面
相对性对比的
So we see many contrasting examples
比如说如果你看使徒行传十二章
So in the Bible for example if you look at Acts chapter 12
十二章记载什么
What does it record
记载耶稣的门徒雅各被叙利王杀掉了在监牢抓去关在监牢里面然后呢把他杀掉了
So it records how John was killed by Herod
那大家很高兴叙利王说可能我把这个人杀掉大家都鼓掌叫好好继续迫害基督徒现在把彼得也抓来了
So after Herod had killed James and the crowd cheered he said to himself maybe I should continue persecuting Christians and he arrested Peter as well
彼得有被杀掉吗
So was Peter killed
你会发现我们的神出手救彼得哦
So we find that our Lord stretched out his hand to save Peter
那是耶稣比较爱彼得耶稣比较不喜欢雅各是这样吗
So is it to say that Jesus loved Peter more than James
不然一样都是被抓在监牢里面耶稣让这个人死掉 被杀死掉耶稣说这个人我救他那耶稣偏心吗
So because both of them were in prison but yet Jesus saved one but not the other is he partial
你看这个施洗约翰那么也被叙利王抓去在监牢里面
So we see that John the Baptist himself was also imprisoned by Herod
那后来呢后来也被砍头死掉耶稣有没有伸手救他没有啊
And he was beheaded and he died Did Jesus save him?
那你再看到但以理书但以理那三个朋友
And we turn to Daniel's three friends
这个烧了七倍的火人要丢他的兵丁都被火烤死了你看那个火多焰啊火焰多大
So they were thrown into the fiery furnace where the people throwing them in were burned to death.
Okay, 那就是丢到火里面的生命还是得到神的保存啊。
So even though they were thrown into the furnace, their lives were preserved.
所以我从这个地方我去做思考啊。
So I
我要强调的是什么呢？死在主里面最重要。
So the point is that it is most important to die in the Lord.
活几岁不重要。
It does not matter how long we live.
摩西活了几岁
So how long did Moses live for?
120岁对不对
120
years 请问他死法是什么
So how did he die?
无灾无病因为死的时候精神没有衰败眼睛没有昏花
He died in a good state where he had good health and his eyes did not fail him
我们可以说他叫寿终正寝啊怎么办寿终正寝怎么办就是说 很安详的活到年纪老迈
So he died
而且死得很舒服这样子
So he died peacefully at an old age and died comfortably
那你看以赛亚先知怎么死的
So how did the prophet Isaiah die?
教会历史上说他是被锯子锯死的。
So in the history of the Bible, it records that he was sawed to death.
他一辈子为神工作最少六十年。
So he worked for God his whole life, which is about 60 years.
所以圣经学家推测这个人大概活八十到九十岁。
So scholars estimate that he had lived for around 80 to 90 years.
那你看耶稣基督怎么死的？
So how did Jesus die?
活了三十三岁，钉十字架死的。
So he lived till he was 33 and was crucified on the cross.
施洗约翰呢？活了差不多三十岁，然后呢？然后被砍头死掉的。
So John the Baptist lived to around 30 years and he was beheaded and he died.
那彼得呢？教会历史上说他是倒钉十字架死的，因为他觉得不配跟耶稣一起钉十字架。
Peter died by being crucified and being turned around upside down because he thought he wasn't worthy to die like Jesus Christ.
活几岁很重要吗？如果从圣经的角度来看，不重要。
So it is not important to what age we live.
用什么方式离开这个世界很重要吗？被车子撞死就不重要什么？一定要死在病床上，死在我们家的这个什么我睡觉的床上，这个才重要什么？你从圣经来看，不是这样。
Does it matter how we die, whether we were run down by a car or we die on a deathbed?
但是他们有一个共同的一个重要的关键。
But they all have one common trait.
好像苏提环石头打死的，但关键是死在主里面。
So when Stephen was stoned to death, there was a key point where he died in the Lord.
所以我们要了解的就是说，我们如果要被神迎接进入神的国度里面。
So one key point for us to understand, if we want to be received up into His
glory, 那你要死在主里面，才能够被迎接进入到神荣耀的国度里面呢。
So only if we die in the Lord can we be received up into His glorious kingdom.
那你就要来看耶稣喽。我们就讲一个重点哈，耶稣他绝对遵守神的真理。
So if we look at Jesus and if there's one point we can take away from him, is that he followed God's commandments absolutely.
看马太福音第三章。
We can turn to Matthew chapter 3.
马太福音第三章十五节。
Matthew chapter 3 verse 15.
这个是耶稣要接受施洗约翰的这个洗礼。
So this is when Jesus was about to receive the baptism of John the Baptist.
那当时约翰不为他洗。
But John the Baptist did not do it for him.
因为耶稣基督是没有罪的，他只是代替罪、代罪的羔羊。
Because Jesus himself was sinless, he was only the lamb who was to bear all sins.
那耶稣他告诉施洗约翰什么呢？
So what did Jesus say to John?
他说你暂且许我。
So he said to him, permit it to be so now.
我用比较社会化的口吻这样讲。
So more colloquially.
约翰你懂也好，你不懂也好，我跟你讲，为我洗就对了。
So whether John the Baptist, you understand this or not, just baptize me.
好，就叫你暂且许我，你不要跟我问那么多，你也不必要考虑那么多，你就为我洗就对了。
So this is what it means when he said, permit it to be so now.
那耶稣讲了一句话。
So Jesus said,
他说因为我们理当这样尽诸般的义。
For thus it is fitting for us to fulfill all righteousness.
那什么叫做义呢？
So what is righteousness?
我们已经解经看生命记第六章。
So let us turn to Deuteronomy chapter 6.
生命记第六章二十五节。
Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 25.
生命记六章二十五节。
Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 25.
我们若照耶和华我们神所吩咐的一切诫命谨守遵行，这就是我们的义了。耶稣说我们要尽诸般的义。
So Jesus tells us that we have to enter all righteousness.
那耶稣的意思就是说我们要按照天上这位神他所告诉我们的话来执行，我们要谨守而且要遵行。
So we must be careful to observe all the commandments given to us by our Lord, our God.
那我们在他的面前，我们就是一个义人啊。
So if we observe his commandments before him, we will be a righteous person.
那义人才有资格被神迎接进入神的国度里面。
Only the righteous are qualified to be received up into the glorious kingdom of God.
所以耶稣对这一本，对这个这个耶和华真神所告诉他的话，他是非常的在意啊，他不敢违背。
So Jesus took what the Lord God said to him very seriously and he did not dare go against it.
我们来举一个例子跟大家做分享。
So we can share one example.
耶稣被钉十字架之前，曾经有罗马兵丁要来抓他。
So before Jesus was crucified, there were Roman soldiers who were about to arrest him.
我现在讲的背景是马太福音二十六章五十一节以下的经文。
So the background is in Matthew chapter 26, verses 51 onwards.
那当这些罗马兵丁要来抓耶稣的时候
，So when these Roman soldiers came to arrest Jesus,
当时彼得很勇敢啊，挺身而出啊，刀子拔出来啊。
So Peter was courageous and he pulled out, drew his sword.
然后把这个大祭司的仆人叫马勒古的耳朵都削掉了。
And he struck the servant of the high priest.
那这个时候耶稣怎么说呢？
But what did Jesus say to him?
耶稣说刀子收起来，不要动刀。
Put your sword in its place.
所以耶稣先讲，你想我现在可不可以求天上的父差派十二营多的天使来救我，来保护我。
Or do you think that I cannot now pray to my father and he will provide me with more than 12 legions of angels?
可以的啦，怎么不可以呢？
Of course you could do so.
罗马军队的这个步皇，罗马军队的编制一营是六千人。
So one company of Roman soldiers has 多少？
六千人，一营六千人。
6,000 soldiers.
那十二营多，超过七万两千个天使啊。
So of course,
12
legions, so you multiply by 6,000, there will be
那你看旧约时代，在西西家王的时代，亚述王的大军要来攻打，要来攻打他的国家，西西家王带领的犹大国。
So during the time of King Hezekiah, the Assyrians wanted to attack his kingdom.
西西家王祷告求神。
And King Hezekiah prayed to
God. 我们的神为他征战。
And our God fought for them.
派了几个天使。
How many angels did he send?
一夜杀掉了十八万五千人，把亚述帝国的兵丁一夜全部都杀掉，派了几个天使。
And in one evening, he sent angels and killed off 180,500 soldiers.
你去找，你去找，一个天使，只有一个。
And if we
一个天使一个晚上就杀掉十八万五千人。
And if we study this carefully, he only sent one angel who did all of this in one night.
现在七万两千多。哇，这个势力，你看这个保护是多么的稳固啊
！So we can only imagine how great this protection would be provided by 72,000 soldiers.
那耶稣说我不必了，不必。
So, but Jesus said to him, "I do not need this."
好，所以耶稣在马太福音二十六章的五十四节。
So in Matthew chapter 26, verse 54.
他说：“如果我这样做了
，So if I did this.
那圣经上所说的事情必须如此的话，怎么应验呢？”
How then could the scriptures be fulfilled that it must happen?
那到底是哪一件事情？耶稣在这里马太福音没有记载啊。
So what event was Jesus referring to?
那是我们对观福音，马太、马可、路加叫对观福音嘛，这边没有记载，另外一卷有记载。
So in the synoptic gospels, the other gospel would have recorded this.
我们来看路加福音二十二章。
So we can turn to Luke chapter 22.
路加福音二十二章三十七节。
Luke 22:37.
到底哪一句话耶稣这么重视呢
？So what sentence or what thing did Jesus emphasize？
这句话叫做“他被列在罪犯之中”，这个话必须应验在我身上。
So and he was numbered with the transgressors for the things concerning me have an end。
因为跟耶稣基督相关，耶稣说一定要成就，我要被列在罪犯之中。
Because what was written concerns Jesus Christ, so that he was numbered with the transgressors, and this must be accomplished.
那这句话记载在以赛亚书五十三章的十二节。
And this is recorded in Isaiah 53 verse 12.
这个是这一节当中的一小段哦。一节讲了很多东西，其中的一小段就是说，这个耶稣将来要被列在罪犯之中，就这么一小段一部分。
So this is a small excerpt among many other things that were mentioned concerning Jesus Christ.
以赛亚书五十三章十二节，大家可以去看。
So we can in our own time look at Isaiah 53 verse 12.
所以我们的神，他一辈子耶稣基督，他就是完全遵照天父给他的话，然后他去执行神的真理。
So throughout his whole life, Jesus followed every a word that was spoken by God and he put it into practice.
然后他走完了神托付给他的人生的道路之后,
And after he had completed his journey of life that God has given to him,
那么他就被迎接进入到神的光啊，就是神的荣耀里面去了。
He was then received up into God's light, which is God's glory.
那在这样子的一个敬虔的奥秘当中
So in this mystery of godliness,
我们要学习的什么叫做敬虔的生活。
So we are able to learn how to live a life of godliness.
我们请看犹大书十八节。
We can turn to the book of Jude, verse 18.
请看犹大书十八节。
Jude, verse 18.
他们曾对你们说过，末世必有好讥笑的人，随从自己不敬虔的私欲而行。我们反面去做思考。
So how they told you that there would be mockers in the last time who walk according to their own ungodly lusts. We can think of it in the opposite
way. 那所谓敬虔就是不按照私欲，不按照我个人的想法，不按照我个人的，我个人的需要，不按照我个人的意见，那么我去行这一条世界的道路。
So, one who is supposedly godly would do and live a life according to their own desires and their own intentions.
你看彼得后书三章第三节。
We can turn to 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 3.
那么这段经文就提到彼得的时代已经有一些人按照他们的想法去看神的道理了。
So even during Peter's time, there were already people who looked at God's truth in their own ways.
我们可以从三节看到第七节
Can read from verses 3 to 7.
所以他们觉得说，好讥笑的人随从自己的私欲出来讥笑说，神的应许在哪里？神所说的话会成就，真的还假的？假的啦，这个都是参考而已啦。
So the scoffers who come in the last days, walking according to their own lust and saying, what is the promise of his coming?
神说要毁灭天，要毁灭世界，到现在世界存留多久了？哪有要毁灭？假的啦，不必太在乎了。
So they would say, oh, God promised that he would come to destroy the earth, but it has not happened now, so this must be all false.
所以我们今天讲一个敬虔的生活，敬虔的生活是什么？不是按照我的意思活在这个世界上。
So to live a godly life is not live according to my own will.
我们看到耶稣基督被接到荣耀，我们跟他走一样的道路，一个重点是什么？请你遵照神的真理来走。
So in order to be received up into glory, like Jesus as he walked in this earth, what is the one thing that we must do is to observe God's commandments.
Okay, 就像约翰三书的第三节跟第四节所说的。
Just as it's written in 3 John, verses 3 and 4.
我们的神最喜悦的一件事情是什么呢？
So what is one thing that pleases God the most?
就是看见他的儿女能够照着他的真理而行。
That God has no greater joy than to hear that his children walk in truth.
神说我的喜乐绝对没有比这个更大的。
And God declares that there is no greater joy than this.
所以我们要过敬虔的生活，要被神接到荣耀里面。
So we must live a life of godliness so that we will be received up into his glory.
那我们就依照神的真理来走世间的天国的信仰道路。
So to walk on this journey of faith and to observe all his truth and his commandments.
那么这个就是我们应当要追求的敬虔的生活。
This must be our pursuit in our life of godliness.
好，我们一起来唱赞美诗204首。
Let us all sing hymn 204.